entertainment right now, and we start with an election story involving Kanye West. For the first time ever, Kanye voted in a U.S. election, and guess who he voted for? Himself. Yes, he took to Twitter to say this: "God is so good today, I'm voting for the first time in my life for the President of the United States, and it's for someone I truly trust, me." Now, he, of course, launched his campaign for the White House after those erratic statements on social media in July. He's on the official ballot in a handful of U.S. states, but obviously no chance of winning. And some analysts believe that his run could siphon black supporters away from Joe Biden in the election as results keep coming in. But there you go. Kanye finally voted, and in typical fashion, he voted for himself. Meanwhile, pop star Britney Spears reassuring fans that her mental health is fine and she's the happiest she's ever been. Now, her business and personal affairs have been controlled by her father since 2008. In a video on Instagram, she addressed persistent reports that she's not doing well. This comes after a small but vocal group of fans launched a hashtag Free Britney campaign to seek an end to a court-ordered conservatorship that put in place after she suffered that mental breakdown some 12 years ago. But she's saying she's okay. And Bruce Springsteen once again reminding us why he is the boss. After the October 23rd release of his latest album, that is his 21st no less, that's called With Letter to You, he made rock history. He's the first artist to have top five album on the Billboard 200 chart for six consecutive decades. His first hit on Billboard goes all the way back to 1975 with the history-ranking record Born to Run. That rose to number three and landed him on the cover of Time and Newsweek in the same week. Much more BT to come, and we'll be paying close attention to